All I do is dream of you the whole night through. With the dawn, I still go on dreaming of you. You're every thought, you're everything, you're every song I ever sing. Summer, winter, autumn, and spring. And were there more than 24 hours a day, they'd be spent in sweet content, dreaming away. The skies are gray, the skies are blue, morning, noon, and nighttime too. All I do, the whole day through, is dream of you. Hi, Jimmy Moreno. Hi, Tacy Heald. Hi, Sandy DiStefano. Hi, Tammy Hoffman. Hi, Jimmy. I already said hi to Jimmy. Hi, Karin Smith. Hi, Rosie. Rosie Rat, watching from Boston tonight. Hi, Marcos Enrique. Enriquez. Hi, Michael Kennedy. Hi, Toledo TD. Hi, Banjo Boy. Hi, Rich Pedersen. And were there more than 24 hours a day? Ah, they'd be spent in sweet content, dreaming away. The skies are gray, the skies are blue, morning, noon, and nighttime too. All I do the whole day through is dream of you. Ga-da-ga-da-ga-da-ga. My favorite day of the week. Welcome, everybody. Let's go. Hi, Charlotte McCarthy. Hi, Di. Hi, Kevin Walter. Hi, Elaine. Watching from Buffalo, New York. Hi, Elaine Grasty. Hi, Terry McFadden Abrams. Hi, David Kress. The gang's all here. Let's go. I'm Kat Edmonson.
That's me.
I was on a 40-city tour celebrating the release of my new record, Dreamers Do, when the pandemic struck. Tour was cut short, so now I'm performing from my living room every Sunday night, singing my songs and your requests. It's the Kat Edmonson Show. Is written by Nacio, Herb Brown, and Arthur Freed, written in the 30s. And I learned it from the movie Singing in the Rain, which Debbie Reynolds sang in that film. I love that song, and I'm so glad to be here with all of you tonight. This is the second day of spring in the United States, and it feels like spring. Magically, somehow, the way they organize it all in the calendar, the weather actually turned this week, and it felt like spring, and I've been so distracted these last few days. Well, this is a song that I prepared, one of the songs to celebrate spring, and it just so happened that somebody requested this today as well. So this one's for you, Leo Divine, and for all of you who are celebrating spring today. This is They Say It's Spring. When I was young, I lived in a world of dreams, of moods and myths and illusionary schemes. Though now I'm much more grown up, I feel that I must own up to the fact that I'm in doubt of what the modern cynics shout of. They say it's spring. This feeling light as a feather. They say this thing. This magic we share together came with the weather too. They say it's May that's made me daft as a daisy. It's May, they say, that gave the whole world this crazy, heavenly, hazy hue. I'm a lark on a wing. I'm the spark of a firefly's fling. Yet to me, this must be something more than a seasonal thing. Could it be spring? Those bells that I can hear ringing. It may be spring, but when the robin stops singing, you're what I'm clinging to. Though they say it's spring, it's you. This is Roy Dunlap on piano. Happy spring, Christina Kulik music. Hi, Kelly Golightly, Ilana Judasic, and Felix. Hi, Michael Tobin, watching from the UK. If poets sing that when a heart's sympathetic, it's merely spring, then poets' plights are pathetic, though I'm poetic too. Oh, they say it's spring, though they say it's spring. I know that it's spring, but it's you. It's you. Whoa, it's you. That's obnoxious. The song just keeps going. This is Roy Dunlap on piano. I didn't remember that the arrangement went that way. And now I'm getting angry. If I had known that, I would have sung the other verses. We're gonna do that one again next week. It just got really hot in here. Hi, Natalie Norris. Hi, Angela Joan Cannon. Thanks for watching from Facebook. Hi, Alan Bowes. I swear I practiced that arrangement before the show. I don't know what happened. Hi, Susanna Partridge Eaton. Susan, thank you. Thanks for watching. Hi, Shannon Brackett. Hi, Cyrus Alderwood. And Nixon Wampamba. It is Wampamba. It's quite late in the UK, you say. Absolutely it is. What is this, a 6-hour difference? Thanks for staying up with us. So you're up late, and some people are eating their sugary cereal, Isabel Gonzalo, and watching this over breakfast. And wherever you are, we're so grateful. And we're celebrating spring. Here's another one about spring, written by Tom Waits. I got to record this when a wonderful guy named Warren Zanes, who's a musician and a writer. In fact, he wrote the biography for Tom Petty that came out not too long ago. And he and I were on a show together a couple years ago now in New York, and he asked me, not long after that, if I would sing on this record that he was producing for Dual Tone Records, Women Sing Waits. And I was so honored because it was an incredible lineup of women, a lot of them that I admired and some of them that I was just learning about. And this is Tom Waits' song called You Can Never Hold Back Spring. You can never hold back spring. You can be sure I will never stop believing. The blushing rose, it will climb. Spring ahead or fall behind. Winter dreams the same dream every time. Baby, you can never hold back spring. And even though you've lost your way, the world is dreaming, dreaming of spring. So close your eyes, open your heart to the one who's dreaming of you. And baby, you can never hold back spring. Remember everything that spring will bring. Baby, you can never hold back spring. That was produced by Mitchell Froom, and it was so great to work with Mitchell again. Warren Zanes, who asked me to record that, had also worked with Mitchell years before with his band, the Del Fuegos. And we both had our love of Mitchell in common. And so Warren said, you can sing this song on the Waits album contingent upon working with Mitchell. I mean, he didn't say it in those words, but that was the deal. I love working with Mitchell. His arrangements are so lush and they sound like outer space. That's how they sound to me. Do they sound like that to you? I think it's a beautiful song too. Thanks, George McCarthy. Hi, Samuel Hermanson. Hi, Sheila Ramish, watching from Austin. Denny Garcia. Hi. Konnichiwa. Someone is watching from Japan via Periscope. Thank you so much. I'm looking forward to coming back to Japan. We were supposed to come to Japan in the spring of last year to promote Dreamers Do, my new album. And then, of course, we had to cancel because of the pandemic. But we hope to make it back to play the Blue Note or the Cotton Club, where we like to play. Hi, Beth Naji. Hi, Herb Ramon. Hi, Juan Delgado. He says he's supposed to be doing laundry, but here he is. We encourage you to be here instead of doing your laundry, whatever that means. Hi, AJ Touchstone. Hi, Lester. Lester is asking if Christina Kulik and I will be doing the song Bosom Buddies soon. If you'd watched us in our, we did a duet of the song Sisters from the movie White Christmas, the Irving Berlin song. And I promised that we would do the song Bosom Buddies because I think Lester and Thomas requested it. We haven't gotten around to working on it, Lester, but we're definitely going to do that song. And Christina, I think we need to do it soon. Hi, Don Cron. Don feels the heat, too. Yes, that made me angry. I was so excited about singing They Say It's Spring, and there I just messed it up. Hi, Deborah Shepherd Willett. Hi, Monica Rico. But didn't Roy play that beautifully? So we'll do that again next week, because it's still going to be spring next week, so I hear. How about this next one? Karen Smith, you requested this some weeks back, and I've been so excited to sing it for you, but I wanted to wait until spring was here to sing it, because I thought it'd be great to usher in the season. This was written in 1946 by Joseph Myro, with lyrics by Mac Gordon. And it was originally released in a movie that I haven't seen yet called The Three Little Girls in Blue, starring Vera Ellen. Now, if you don't recognize her name, she was in the movie White Christmas. Maybe you'll remember her then. She was the fabulous dancer that played opposite Rosemary Clooney in White Christmas. She was the one that had the leg that wouldn't stop. Do you know what I'm talking about? That scene when she's tapping, and she's tapping so fast. It's like she's like a hummingbird, her tiny little frame. It's a wonder that she exists, that she existed. I don't think she's alive anymore. Anyway, Vera Ellen debuted this song in that movie, and it actually wasn't her voice singing it. Someone by the name of Carol Stewart sang it and overdubbed it for her. This is You Make Me Feel So Young. You make me feel so young. You make me feel like spring is sprung. And every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual. The moment that you speak, I wanna go and play hide and seek. I wanna go and bounce the moon, just like a toy balloon. You and I, we are just like a couple of tots, running around the meadow, picking up lots of forget-me-nots. Oh, you make me feel so young. You make me feel there are songs to be sung, bells to be rung, and a wonderful fling to be flung. And even when I'm old and gray, I'm gonna feel the way I do today, because you make me feel so young. Take it away, Roy. You make me feel. Hi, Karen. Hi, Wilfried Wald. Roy Dunlap. A couple of tots, hey, running around the meadow, picking up all those forget-me-nots. Oh, you make me feel so young. You make me feel there are songs to be sung, bells to be rung, and a wonderful fling to be flung. And even when I'm old and gray, I'm gonna feel the way I do today, because you make me feel so young. You make me feel so young. Ooh, you make me feel. Ooh, you make me feel so young. I feel so young. And of course, that was the arrangement that Nelson Riddle wrote for Frank Sinatra on his album Songs for Swinging Lovers. And I always think how that album title might be interpreted differently were it released today. That's one of my favorite records of all time. And maybe you've heard me say it before, but when I was in high school, and incidentally, none of my peers at the time knew that I was doing this because I was listening to other music with my friends. But when I was in high school, my mom would leave the house, I would blast that record and play it from start to finish and sometimes on repeat. I love that album and I love Nelson Riddle's orchestrations. Hi, Al Stein. Will Friedwald said it's side one, track one. There you go. Will Friedwald. Okay, everybody, I was watching Will Friedwald this week, and I shared a link to watch him earlier this week. Maybe you saw it. You can go and look on my Facebook page and see the post that I made. But I want to share Will Friedwald's information again. You can watch some of his archived shows, and he has a show every week, just like I do, called Clip Joint, where he presents fabulous clips from history, like great entertainment from many decades, a lot of variety shows and live performances. And I don't know where you get all your clips, Will, but the show goes on for hours and it's so amazing. If you love a lot of old music like I do, I think you'd love Will's show. Again, it's called Clip Joint, and he says his show is on three times a week at least, but not on Sunday evening. So we're going to post a link to Clip Joint so everybody can watch. And I'm just going to continue to promote your show, Will, because it's a gem, and we're lucky to have you and all that you know. Everybody, you can purchase your ticket tonight by going to cat.live. It's pay what you will. And because of your weekly contributions, we are able to come back week after week. We never anticipated having 43 episodes when we started, but we're amazed and just so grateful. And the reason why we can keep going is only because of you. So we appreciate any contribution you can make, and every contribution you make. And most of all, we just love to see you coming back week after week. All right. This next song is also a song about spring, but sung from a little bit of a different perspective. The first time I heard this tune, I was sitting in a living room, a friend's living room, and I believe it was springtime. I was visiting New York. I didn't yet live there. And I had my headphones in. I was listening to an iPod. That's how old that was. And this tune came on. I'd never heard it before. And it stopped me in my tracks. And I was enamored with it immediately. And did I mention it was Blossom Dearie and her beautiful piano playing? This song was written in 1955 by Fran Landesman and Tommy Wolfe. I'll tell you a little bit more about how they wrote it after I sing this. This is Spring Can Really Hang You Up the Most. Once I was a sentimental thing. I threw my heart away each spring. But now a spring romance hasn't got a chance. Promised my first dance to winter. got to shows a splinter for my little fling. Spring this year has got me feeling like a horse that never left the post. I lie in my room, staring up at the ceiling. Spring can really hang you up the most. Morning's kiss wakes trees and flowers, and to them I'd like to drink a toast. I walk through the park just to kill the lonely hours. Spring can really hang you up the most. All afternoon, the birds twitter twit. I know the tune. This is love. This is it. Spring came along. A season of song, full of sweet promise. But something went wrong. Love seemed sure around the new year. Now it's April, love is just a ghost. Spring arrived on time. Tell me what became of you, dear. Spring can really hang you up the most. All alone, the party's over. Old man Winter was a gracious host. But if you keep praying for snow to hide the clover, spring can really hang you up the most. There are more lyrics to that song, but because the content of those lyrics, I plan to sing them in another show at another time, just for fun. Isn't that a gorgeous song? And it goes through different keys. It's just absolutely beautiful. I wonder what y'all think of it. Ooh, Elaine Grasty requests Make Someone Happy or any old Jimmy Durante piece. You got it, Elaine. We'll do that in the next show. I love Make Someone Happy, and I sing it to myself often. The first time I heard that was actually in the film Sleepless in Seattle. It plays in the opening credits, if any of you remember that. I'm trying to remember the name of the man that wrote the screenplay for Sleepless in Seattle. Ultimately, Nora Ephron and her sister, whose name also escapes me, assisted him in revising the screenplay. But in interviews, she said that the story was all there and the humor was there and everything really was already written. But Nora came along and helped him make this film. Does anyone know? If you do, please put it in the notes. Helped him get this film where it needed to go to ultimately be made. And and they didn't expect it to be the hit that it was. And what a fantastic movie. It's based, well, not based around, it's about two people, divorcees, if you will. Tom Hanks is a widower, and Meg Ryan is soon to be married, but all of these things happen, and they don't even meet until the end of the film. Aaron is just amazed at that. Spoiler alert. Oh, God, you're right. I'm just assuming they've all seen it. I don't know, but here's what I think anyway. You should watch it, and here's the other thing. Every trailer that I watch for a movie these days shows the whole movie. I can't believe it. Every time I watch a trailer now, I can't believe how much they show you. It's like they almost show you the end of the film. And then I wonder why anyone watches them, because I figure I've already seen everything. Spoiler alert, where we just give away the... Aaron thinks it should be a new segment on the show. Yeah, we'll do Make Someone Happy in another show. Sorry, Toledo TD, I just told you too much information, but listen, go see it. Rent it. It's good. Jeff Arch was the story writer. Thanks, Terry McFadden Abrams. Yes. Yes, what a great story writer he was. Wilfried Wald, Rob Reiner did not write it, but he made an appearance in it. And what a great appearance that was. Hi, John Kramer. Thank you. John is appreciating my honesty. I'm afraid I can't help it. Thank you, John. Yeah, Sleepless in Seattle is one of my favorite movies. And recently I read the whole screenplay, which is actually different from the film ultimately. And it's interesting to see the changes that they made. What is next? What's in store for you? Let's see. Oh, well, if you noticed in the last song, spring can really hang you up the most. Written in 1955. Oh, and I promised you that I would tell you how they wrote it. Fran Landesman was sitting at the bar of a nightclub called the Crystal Palace, a nightclub that her husband ran. She was sitting at the bar one night watching the band play, and a pianist and composer, Tommy Wolfe, was playing in the band. Ultimately, the two met that night, and inspired by their meeting, Fran began to write lyrics based around T.S. Eliot's poem, Wasteland, which starts with the line, April is the cruelest month. And the poem is about how in the midst of the glory of spring, one can be feeling sadness and depression. So she was inspired by meeting this man, Tommy Wolfe, and also this poem, and she began to write her own set of lyrics, which Tommy Wolfe ultimately wrote music to. And the two went on to collaborate on writing other songs as well. She also ended up writing with Bob Dureau, a song in particular that Miles Davis recorded, one that she wrote with Bob Dureau. Now, I can't remember which song that was, but she ultimately named one of her sons after Miles Davis. First name Miles, middle name Davis. Anyway, Fran Landesman, I don't think she intended to be a songwriter, but she ultimately became one. She passed away about 10 years ago now. To great fame, she wrote for a lot of singers, and what an interesting life she led. I would like to learn a lot more about her. Hi, Leslie Krause. Hi, I'm so glad you and Carl are here. Leslie mentioned to me this week that she's going to be going in for surgery at the beginning of next month. And so everyone, please join me in wishing Leslie well. Leslie, we'll be thinking of you, and we hope that you will let us know how everything's going and how you're doing, okay? And I have a song for you that we're going to play later. So I mentioned Spring Can Really Hang You Up the most because there's a line in that song, "The party's over, old man Winter was a gracious host." Now let's see, I don't think the original melody is "The party's over." I think it's "The party's over." But anyway, in 1956, for the film Bells Are Ringing, Julie Stein wrote the music to this song, and Betty Comden and Adolph Green wrote the words. And I love this musical. Here's another film that, if you haven't seen, please go and watch. Bells Are Ringing. This is "The Party's Over." Roy Dunlap on piano, Bob Hart on bass, and Aaron Thurston on drums. Party's over, it's time to call it a day. They've burst your pretty balloon and taken the moon away. It's time to wind up the masquerade. Make your mind up, the piper must be paid. The party's over, the candles flicker and dim. You danced and dreamed through the night. It seemed to be right just being with him. Now you must wind up, oh, dreams must end. Make your mind up, no, the party's over. It's all over, my friend. Party's over, it's time to call it a day. Now you must wake up, oh, dreams must end. Take off your makeup, the party's over, it's all over, my friend, it's all over, my friend. What a great arrangement, and that's based on the arrangement that, I don't know who wrote that, for Nat King Cole. Will Friedwald can probably tell us because he wrote a book that was recently published about Nat King Cole, and that book is actually on the way to me right now in the mail. I can't wait to tell y'all about it. Nat King Cole, as some of you may know, is my desert island choice. If I had to choose, that's who I would choose. Billy May wrote the arrangement for Nat King Cole. Now, I'll tell you something really funny that Aaron doesn't know, and no one would know, except that I'm being honest. There was one day, Aaron, when you were off on one side of the house, and you were watching something or listening to something, and you had your earphones on, and I was working on that tune, "The Party's Over." I was listening to the Nat King Cole arrangement, and I was doing like this massive improvised dance number up and down the ladder and all throughout the kitchen and on top of stools and stuff. And you didn't see me at all. There was this huge number going on in the house, and I was just dancing. And actually, sometimes I do that. I just have like a dance explosion behind your back. He said sometimes he knows and he just keeps his earbuds in. And that's what we have to do for each other in a pandemic. That's what we have to do. Oh, he said he's afraid I might have him join me. No. No. We each love to do our thing, and dancing isn't what you love.
This is the Cat Edmonson show. Let's just stick to you.
Aaron says, please, let's stick to Cat Edmonson in the Cat Edmonson show. Carlos Aranaga suggests that we install video monitors. That would be sort of like a reality show, wouldn't it? Hi, Roy Dunlap. He says hello to everyone. Thank you. Hi. Thank you. Wasn't that fabulous? That was Roy Dunlap on piano. Roy Dunlap, everybody. Roy Dunlap is with us in the group. Hello. David Kress is reminding us that Wilfried Wald's book about Nat King Cole is called Straighten Up and Fly Right. That's right, everybody. Go check it out. It's everywhere online. It's at Barnes & Noble. It's at your local bookstore. It's on Amazon. Terry McFadden Abrams says, love, Nature Boy. Well, shall we do that one? Shall we do Nature Boy? I think somebody else requested this today, too, on Facebook. Yeah. There was a boy, a very strange enchanted boy. They say he traveled very far, very far, over land and sea. A little shy and sad of eye, but very wise was he. And then one day, one magic day, he passed my way, and while he spoke of many things, fools and this he said to me, the greatest thing that you'll ever learn is just to love and be loved in return. In return. Woo. Written by Eden Abez. I had to look that up. I couldn't remember his name off the top of my head. Another person who I'm not sure they set out to be a songwriter in their life, but Eden Abez became one, a very whimsical kind of man, often acting on his whimsy, and rather impulsive man, who showed up at a Nat King Cole show, I believe at the Hollywood Bowl, and said, I've written this song, would you like to sing it? That just doesn't usually work out in life, but it did for Eden Abez. All right, Christopher Green Anne Sunny Morgan requested this song, written by my friend, Miles Zuniga, in, I believe, 2010. This is Hopelessly Blue. Okay. I didn't think the day we met would be a day that I regret. I never thought someone like you could make me so hopelessly blue. And now that you have gone away, I tell myself I'll be okay, but my heart knows that ain't true. I wanna feel hopelessly blue. Memories won't let me be. They hang like smoke rings in the air. Are you happy now? Are you happy now? Don't you care? I didn't see what lay ahead. The fault line underneath our bed. The space between us just grew. And now I'm so hopelessly blue. Matt Munisteri on guitar. Recorded that song with Al Schmidt and Phil Ramone in New York City, the late, great Phil Ramone, who produced so many records, including a lot of Paul Simon's records and Billy Joel's records. He worked on the Stan Getz, Astru Gilberto, Girl from Ipanema. He worked on Leslie Gore's It's My Party. He recorded Bob Dylan and the Blood in the Tracks album, which Bob Dylan ultimately re-recorded. But he was a hero of mine, and when I found out that I was going to get to work with him, I was ecstatic. And he was such a wonderful and wise person to have in the studio with us. And when we were working on this song, it was towards the end of our two-day recording session. And we didn't quite know why this song wasn't working. We had Frank Locrasto on piano, Dan Bowler was on bass, Brian Wolfe was playing drums, and we knew we wanted to play it as a ballad. And Phil just dialed in from inside the studio and said, inside the control room, said, use the Rhodes. The Rhodes is the keyboard, that warm, fuzzy keyboard sound that you hear instead of the piano. And that really, it changed the whole song. He was right. And I was so excited to hear that because there were Paul Simon records that he worked on. Did I say McCartney before? I didn't mean to. There were Paul Simon records that he worked on before that used that wonderful Rhodes sound. For instance, Something So Right. You got the cool water when the fever runs high. You know what? We should do that song sometime. Thank you all. Hi, Nancy DeForest. I'm so glad to have you watching. All right. Here's a song that I wrote. It's on my album, Old Fashioned Gal. It's called Not My Time. I auditioned to be a star. With all my ambition, I knew I'd go far. Farthest I got was 49. They said it wasn't my time. A fortune teller. Is that the words? Everybody stop. I don't know what's going on today. It's spring. It's true, I've been distracted all day. Speaking of distraction, I wanted to tell you I was in my kitchen today and I looked out the window and there were two cardinals and it looked like they were playing chase. It looked like one was chasing the other. And I thought, well, it certainly is spring. These two beautiful cardinals. Okay, are my lyrics posted online? Because I'm looking for them. I auditioned to be a star. With all my ambition, I knew I'd go far. Farthest I got was 49. They said it wasn't my time. A fortune teller assessed my hand. Well, this is a lesson in trusting yourself. Hit it, Aaron. 2, 3, 4. Auditioned to be a star. With all my ambition, I knew I'd go far. Farthest I got was 49. They said it wasn't my time. A fortune teller assessed my hand and then shook her head as I told her my plans. Told me my planets weren't aligned. She said, it's not your time. I imagine all the many things I could do. But then I'd go and try to see them through. Thought I could... there I was knocking on death's door, when death opened up and asked me what for, told me I had to wait in line. He said it's not your time. Thought I could model, live the high life, but on my way up, got cut off at 5. They said, unless you get to 5'9", maybe it isn't your time. Guess it isn't my time. I guess it's not my time. I don't know what in the world is going on, but I have to learn my own song again. Hi, Ernesto Martinez. Thanks for tuning in. My friend Ernesto is watching. Hi, Kimberly Carlson. She thinks it is my time. Thanks, Kimberly. Thanks, Amy Jo Aleo. Yes, I did my best. When in doubt, mouth trumpet. That's my mouth trumpet, although other people have identified it as a trombone sound. Whatever, we do our best. This one is for you, Leslie Krause. This is a song that I wrote recently. It came out this month. This month isn't over. It's still March. But it feels like this song came out weeks and weeks ago. This is If You're Scared. Do ya beat-a by you, beat-a bum bum bum, just a bad dream. That's all, that's what you hope someone might say to make it go away, but it ain't going. And your fears are growing shadows on your wall, setting traps which you might fall. Oh, maybe it's all too much for you to bear. Oh, and maybe you feel uncertain and unprepared. There, if you're scared and nothing will console you, call on me and I will be right there. When the situation isn't fair, I will hold you when it's cold out. People have sold you out for fairer weather, when you can't keep it you're scared and nothing will console you, call on me and I will be right there. When the situation isn't fair, I will hold you if you're scared. I would if I could make it go away, I'd fix it up and make it better than it was before. I'd take the whole thing on so you wouldn't have to face it. But it seems all I can do is help you to embrace it. So let's face it. Together, and even when I can't be near, you know that I am here. If you're scared and nothing will console you, call on me. Situation isn't fair, I will hold you if you're scared. And la 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 la. Had a bad week, and she says those lyrics helped. I'm so glad, Natalie. And take that song with you, Leslie. Hi, Steven Rosenberg. Just got home from work and turned on the show. Oh, thanks. Oh, he's consoling me because I got lost in the tune. Yes, indeed, we all lose our way. It happens, as they say. Thanks, Tazy Healed. Hi, Ferg 5x5. We have people watching from YouTube, Facebook, Twitch, and Twitter, or Periscope, as it's called. Everyone, you can purchase your ticket tonight by going to cat.live, and every contribution you make makes it possible for us to come back the following week. When you pay digitally online, you'll notice a notation back that says something, it's a receipt from Nine Lives Touring, and that's us. That's only if you pay by PayPal, Aaron said. And he said, he's indicating that I didn't need to tell you that, but as you appreciate my honesty, I was happy to do it. So those are all the songs that I wrote down for the week. I mean, there are a few more here that I thought would be fun to play, but why don't we open it up to requests? And speaking of requests, have you all been thinking about the Cat Edmonson Show Gang name? I mean, the Cat Edmonson Show Gang is pretty cool. Right? I was, Aaron was like, it's not that kind of a gang. We're more inclusive, less threatening or threatened, really. But for that very reason, in fact, I was really inspired by someone's suggestion of the Dreamers last week, Cat and the Dreamers. I think that was kind of cool. Will Friedwald is asking for Second Star to the Right. You got it, Will. All right, so Second Star to the Right was written by Sammy Fain and I believe Sammy Kahn. But, you know, given my memory tonight, I'm going to double check and make sure. We recorded this on my album, Dreamers Do, and we have a wonderful video of us making this live in the studio. And if you haven't seen it, you can check it out on my YouTube page. And while you're there, please subscribe. It's free to subscribe. Sammy Fain and Sammy Kahn. Yeah, Aaron's laughing. What's going on? Good idea. Will Friedwald is suggesting we get a sponsor like Chevrolet. Or Purina. Yes. Meow Mix. Yes. Meow Mix for the Cat Edmonson Show.
Or Moet for Champagne.
Moet for Champagne. That's a good idea. I thought I might sing that song tonight. Maybe we'll do Champagne Does It Every Time. Yes, Ferg 5x5 noticed that we almost have 10,000 subscribers on YouTube. We are so close, Ferg. So if you aren't subscribed and you watch things on YouTube, you might as well subscribe to my channel because you'll get the notifications right when something comes out. And I post things pretty frequently.
Also, someone says they appreciate the comment about saying 9
last 12. Oh, Aaron stands corrected. Someone said they appreciate the comment about 9 Lives touring. Perhaps they were thrown off when they saw it, when they made their purchase on PayPal. But then if you really think hard, 9 Lives touring is kind of a cute name for Cat Edmonson, isn't it? What's that song that we were going to do? The Second Star to the Right. I know the lyrics to this one. Isn't that funny? It's not mine. And I remember the lyrics to this one. This is Roy Dunlap on piano. Second star to the right shines in the night for you to show you all the things you planned really can come true. The second star to the right shines with a light so if it's Neverland you need, its light will lead you there. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, so we'll know where you are. Gleaming in the skies above, lead us to we dream of. And when our journey is through, each time we say good night, we'll thank the little star that shines the second from the right. Bob Hart on bass. Rob Schwimmer on Hagen Continuum, which is a the keyboard. We knew what feeling we wanted to get to in the studio. So we had that goal. We had an idea of how we'd get there, but what's amazing about that recording and many other songs on the album Dreamers Do, and I'm going to hold it up for you since I'm talking about it. This record. You know, there's different approaches to making records. And sometimes you know exactly what you're going to play before you go in the studio. And you just play it down. And then sometimes, if there's a lot of production on it, these days what happens is you'll lay down the rhythm tracks. And then you'll start adding in, one person at a time maybe, will go into the studio and everyone else will be in the control room, perhaps. And you'll just keep coming up with more and more ideas to layer into the song. And you just keep folding more and more ingredients. And a lot of times you just put a whole bunch of stuff in there and then eventually extract the things that aren't working to come up with the song that you're going for. That's really a pop kind of approach. In this case, we had the bones of what we were working with. We had some idea of course, the chords that we were going to play. But we didn't know exactly how we were going to get to where we were going. And so what's captured on that recording was really happening in the moment. Like we were surprised. We were hearing it the first time the same way that you do when you hear it the first time. And so I get this wonderful experience of that every time I listen to it. And that, it, you can't do that without musicianship. So these guys in my band are top drawer players, as my dear friend Christina Kulik would say. And they're all skilled and talented enough that we can go in with just the basic ideas and create something in the moment. And that's how I like to record. That's the most beautiful way to work to me, because I like to be surprised. I can't wait till we can go back on the road and play together again. And maybe it'll happen this year. So stay tuned and keep looking. We might be able to play shows this year and maybe in your city. And those dates would be available at cat.live, as everything else is. Karen Dixon is watching from Charlotte, North Carolina. I'm so glad you like that album. Thanks, Mom. Hi, Jennifer Rittner. How about a champagne that does it every time? This is a song that I wrote and released on my album Way Down Low. A champagne. The night they invented champagne. I don't know all the words, but my mother does. If she were here, I would say, come on! mother, get on the stage and sing the night they invented champagne from Gigi. But instead, I'm just gonna sing my song. Hit it, Aaron. I'm never gonna drink again. At least not with the finer men. Oh, well, at a celebration, offering libations from the appellation, I couldn't resist one little kiss. But now the Bacchic thrill is gone. I didn't mean to lead you on. My heart was not the one behind this amatory crime. No champagne does it every time. This is Matt Ray on piano. Taking the equation of the fermentation and a cool persuasion, I've got no hope. I'm such a dope in wine historiography. You find me under fancy free. Can't be held accountable. My word's not worth a dime when champagne does it every time, baby. Yeah, but when champagne does it, ooh, bubbles do it when champagne does it. Bubbles do it. By the way, I want to go back to a comment Will Friedwald made. He corrected me about Eden Abes earlier. He said that Eden Abes actually brought Nat Cole, Nature Boy, at Lincoln Center. And that's all I can say. You probably saw it as it went by in the comments. But thanks for correcting us, Will. We love the extra information. We love when you share what you know here. Hi, Christopher Sevick. Hi, Casey Sheets Ballard. Thank you. Citizen Debs. Oh, Citizen Debs was playing along to that. What were you playing on, piano? That's cool. Citizen Debs plays by ear. No, Will Friedwald, we love when you nerd out. Lincoln Theater, not Lincoln Center. Thank you. Yes. Eden Abes gave Nat King Cole that song at Lincoln Theater. All right. Well, you all, I've got a couple more tunes for you. Because it's spring here, it's a lot less gray outside. We're seeing a lot more blue skies and sunshine. So I thought we could bring back the good old sunny side of the street. How about that? Mom says, nerd on, Will. What's the symbol for that? Nerd on, man. Nerd on, man. Aaron tried to stop me. Hit it, babe. Grab your coat and get your hat. Leave your worries by the doorstep and just direct your feet to the sunny side of the street. Can't you hear that pitter-pat? What a happy tune is your step. Life is so sweet on the sunny side of the street. I used to walk in the shade with my blues on parade. But now I'm not afraid because this rover crossed over. If I'd never had a cent, I'd be rich as Rockefeller with gold dust at my feet on the sunny, sunny side of the street. Hit it, Roy. Over there and get yourself some sunshine. Everybody, it's been so great performing for you, and I can't believe how much time we've spent together already. Oh. With spring upon us, I started thinking about my wardrobe, and I thought maybe you'd like to watch the COVID fashion video. So after this next song, stay tuned in, and we're gonna play a video for you that we made earlier this year. Now, I'll send you off with that in a little bit, but this is a song that I didn't write, but I recorded way different than the original version. If you're ever interested in checking out the original version, it's by a man named Sonny Henry, and you can go check out Willie Bobo, who recorded this originally. It's a song called I Don't Know, recorded for my second album, Way Down Low. Here we go. Ooh. Ooh. makes me love you so. I don't know. And when you're holding my hand, something happens to me. I feel it way down low. And I don't know how I can hold you, because you are so fine. And I thank my lucky stars for the day I made you mine. And if you ever go, well, I'd be lost without you, and it would hurt me so, way down low. So Willie Bobo, W-L-L-I-E. Fantastic recording. B-O-B-O. Go check it out. This is Matt Moonisteri on guitar. Collard. Good night, R. Thomas Bauer. Good night, David Kress, Jimmy Moreno, Citizen Debs, Leston Farber, Ernesto Martinez. Good night, Beth Nagy. Love you too. See you next week.
Beautiful you in the COVID fashion. Beautiful you. Gonna make a splash in protective gear for the entire year. How they'll cheer, beautiful wares, for every occasion help you beware, and avoid contagion, don't let it through, take care of beautiful you. There will be days in the sun and days in the rain, you get through them all, you'll see. You've got those lips that are meant to be kissed, but not until we're virus free. How beautiful you is like a great work of art. You're stylish, you're chic, and you also are smart.
Before you binge watch Tiger King in those same old pajamas, consider a more festive look. Add your own dash of drama. Find that you've been missing that regular vitamin D? A weekend in these shorties will bring back freckles to those knees. While tending to the azaleas, this bucket hat will never fail ya. While reading Agatha Christie, you're dying to solve the mystery. Before Poirot's gray cells do it for ya, try employing your own fedora. Expecting to be poolside in pseudo-modesty? This cover-up will make your heart sing Olly Olly Oxen Free. And at the chili cookout, where temperatures will be running, in your easy breezy southwest vest, they'll never see you coming. This year's Deb Ball was reduced to a Zoom call, leaving this disgruntled attendee to say, COVID tends to ruin the day. When active at the club, lawn tennis or croquet, this clever little cap will tempt your suitors to say, hey, from working in the garden, to getting vitamin D, to going to the cookout, to watching your TV. The fashion a la mode must abide the strict health code.
Beautiful wares for the COVID season.